Let's begin with news that's coming in. Mehul Choksi has landed in Antigua and Barbuda after he got bail from a Dominican court. He's been staying in Antigua since 2018 after leaving India. He was in custody for 51 days in neighboring Dominica for illegal entry, which his lawyers have claimed was a kidnapping plan. Choksi was given bail by the Dominica High Court to travel back to Antigua to seek medical help from a neurologist based there. This bail has been granted to him only and strictly on medical grounds. Carlisle is joining us live from Dominica with the latest updates on this. Carlisle, thank you for joining us here on India Today. So now we know that Mehul Choksi is back in Antigua. It looks unlikely that he's going to be returning to Dominica anytime now till he's declared fully fit.
Thank you very much. It seems that may very well be the case, because from the order of the judge, it states that unless he is medically fit, he cannot return to Dominica. So it appears it's going to take a long while for Choksi to return back to Dominica. In fact, he may have just gotten his wish, because remember, he wanted, from all reports, to go back to Antigua. He has deposited the $10,000 bail in the treasury of Dominica, and it is there. And the fine basically is $5,000. He has done that. He left today via private aircraft from the Douglas Charles Airport, and he has landed in Antigua. That's at the VC Bird International Airport. Like I said, it's going to take him a long while to return to Dominica. As to how long, we are not exactly sure, but it's clear that Choksi has gotten his wish and is back in Antigua.
Right, this is what he'd have been hoping for, using his medical condition to ensure that he gets some relief. He's secured that from Dominican court. He's now in Antigua. Carlisle, I appreciate you joining us with all those details here on India Today. Let's move on to our top story of the day. Varanasi is all decked up because Prime Minister Modi is returning to his home constituency today. The Prime Minister's got a busy schedule ahead of him. He's going to be inaugurating and laying the foundation stone for projects worth 1,500 crore rupees during his visit. The highlight, however, will be a Rudraksh Convention Centre, which has been built with the assistance from Japan and aims to turn Kashi into a tourism hub. The Prime Minister's visit is also very politically significant, of course, because the state of Uttar Pradesh will be going to polls early next year.
Eight months after his last visit, Prime Minister Narendra Modi will be in his Lok Sabha constituency, Varanasi. The temple town is all decked up for the Prime Minister's grand welcome. From Ganga Aarti to a special song. Prime Minister Modi will be inaugurating a slew of development projects worth over 500 crore rupees. The highlight is the inauguration of Convention Centre Rudraksh. The state-of-the-art center, developed with the assistance of Japan, aims to make the city a tourism hub.
Rudraksh is one of the centers which he will be inaugurating. He will be visiting with many Japanese delegates as well, who will be present over here. And we also believe that there will be a small video message from Japanese Prime Minister Suga as well for the delegates present over here, because this has been built with Japanese support and expertise. And hence, there will be a little bit of a show over here which shows Indo-Japanese culture.
कि जैसे गेट खुले और परमिशन मिले दौड़ी दौड़ी हमें अंदर जाना है बस
मैम बहुत अच्छा लगा देखकर रुद्राज को ऐसा बनाया बनारस में बहुत अच्छा लगा हम लोग को देखकर
बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है तो क्या
लाइट्स लगा के अच्छा
बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है एकदम
A miniature Rudraksh model will also be gifted to the Prime Minister.
Rudraksh Convention Center पे जो ये अंग वस्त्र दिया जाएगा माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी को जिसको लल्लापुरा के Master Shilpi Mumtaz Ali ne banaya hai.
Apart from this, the Prime Minister will inaugurate a 100-bed maternal and child health wing at the Banaras Hindu University and a 3-lane flyover on the Varanasi-Ghazipur Highway. The Prime Minister will also open the Ro-Ro ferry service on Ganga River. That's not all. Narendra Modi will be laying foundation stones for public works projects worth 839 crore rupees. This includes 143 rural projects under the Jal Jeevan Mission.
कि 1550 करोड़ जो सौगात दे रहे हैं वो काशी वासियों के हित में ही है, काशी के डेवलप के लिए ही वो दे रहे हैं यहाँ पे।
कि भारत जापान का प्रतीक तैयार रुद्राक्ष कन्वेंशन
Prime Minister Modi's visit to Varanasi is politically very significant. The tour comes at a time when the BJP is gearing up for the Uttar Pradesh elections a few months later in 2022. With Paulami Saha in Varanasi, Bureau Report, India Today.
It seems some headway has finally been made with regards to the Punjab Congress political crisis. A truce is likely between Punjab Chief Minister Captain Amrinder Singh and firebrand Navjot Singh Sidhu. India Today has learnt that the Congress High Command will dictate its truce formula within the next 2 to 3 days. Sources have indicated to India Today that Navjot Singh Sidhu may get the Punjab Congress chief post under this new formula. The Congress may have two working presidents in the state, which is going to polls next year. There will, however, be no deputy CM post that Sidhu had demanded for himself. Remember, Sidhu has been at loggerheads with the Punjab Chief Minister, attacking him on several occasions and over issues like the alleged delay in a probe into the 2015 desecration of Sikh texts and subsequently firing at police personnel. Sticking to political news, Prashant Kishore's meeting with the Gandhis has sparked massive speculation if he's stitching an anti-Modi alliance ahead of 2024 or if he's lobbying for Sharad Pawar to become president. Now, all of this has also raised questions on whether PK is actually joining the Congress. Political grapevine is a buzz that the master poll strategist has been offered to join the Congress to actually revamp the party. So what exactly is cooking with Prashant Kishore? India Today's Political Bureau decodes.
Months earlier, he scripted Mamta's win in Bengal, only to drop the bombshell of political sannyas.
So I will quit, I will cease to do what I have been doing until now. It's just that I'm glad God has been kind that I'm quitting, I'm able to quit after the victory.
But Prashant Kishore is bang in the center stage again, with back-to-back high-profile political huddles with opposition stalwarts. Thrice with NCP Supremo Sharad Pawar. Then, one big one with Punjab Chief Minister Amrinder Singh. And one crucial meeting with the Gandhis. And two hush-hush ones with Stalin and Naveen Patnaik. The meetings hold immense significance amid approaching state polls, with three possible ramifications. Possibility 1. Mission Rescue Congress. A revived Congress mission. The grand old party is constantly on downhill since 2014, tasting successive defeats and facing leadership rot. While meeting Gandhis, Kishore is said to have given a revival blueprint. Possibility 2. Anti-Modi front.
Narendra Modi!
Kishore may also be stitching together a front to take up the formidable challenge of Narendra Modi. A possible 2024 front, taking baby steps during the opposition meet at NCP Chief Sharad Pawar's residence last month.
ममता जी है वहाँ, शरद पवार साहब है, चंद्रा बाबू है, लालू यादव जी है, अखिलेश जी है, नेता कौन, ये पहले तय होना चाहिए। आज मोदी जी के सामने अगर आपको लड़ना है तो एक चेहरा चाहिए।
पॉसिबिलिटी 3, पवार प्ले फॉर प्रेसिडेंट। पॉलिटिकल सर्कल्स आर अबज ओवर किशोर लॉबिंग फॉर एनसीपी चीफ शरद पवार एज द नेक्स्ट प्रेसिडेंट, क्रंचिंग इलेक्टोरल कॉलेज मैथ which he thinks can install an opposition-backed president if Odisha CM Naveen Patnaik comes on board. Pawar himself has said that reports of him contesting presidential polls are baseless. BJP seems ready for the PK challenge.
इनको क्या है अभी नए नए सेफोलॉजिस्टों को ठेका देने की कोशिश करेंगे. अब जनता पे तो विश्वास रह नहीं गया. इस तरह के जो है वो किराए के जो है वो रणनीतिकारों की तलाश चल रही है कांग्रेस में.
एंड द ऑपोजिशन्स चाणक्य प्रूव अ पोटेंट मैच फॉर नरेंद्र मोदी एंड बीजेपी. विद आनंद पटेल इन दिल्ली, ब्यूरो रिपोर्ट, इंडिया टुडे.
Moving on, India and China held bilateral talks on the sidelines of the Shanghai Cooperation Foreign Ministers meet in Tajikistan. This meeting was held between External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar and his Chinese counterpart Wang Yi. Now, during this meeting, India demanded restoration of the status quo along the line of actual control. Jaishankar said that the change in status quo is affecting ties between the two countries. He called for disengagement in all areas of Ladakh after Pangong. Jaishankar said that the existing situation is not in the interest of India. His meet with Wang Yi went on for an hour and the two have agreed on convening an early meeting of senior military commanders. There was also an understanding that both sides will continue to ensure stability on the ground and neither side will take any unilateral action that could raise tensions. Congress leader and MP Rahul Gandhi is hit out at the Narendra Modi government, accusing it of weakening India. Rahul claimed that India had never been this vulnerable. The BJP hit right back, accusing Rahul Gandhi of using fake news as a domestic political tool, insisting it was a new low even by Rahul's standards. Our political bureau brings you this story.
Border politics has escalated once again. Congress MP Rahul Gandhi and other Congress MPs staged a walkout of the Parliamentary Standing Committee on Defence, demanding a discussion on Doklam and other border issues. But the chair did not accept his demand. The meeting was to discuss cantonment boards. Rahul Gandhi wanted the meeting to reconvene and discuss the border issues, but that too was denied. This comes right after Rahul Gandhi hit out at the central government over reports of a fresh clash between Indian and Chinese forces at the LSE. Rahul Gandhi took to Twitter and slammed the Modi government, saying that the centre is using foreign and defence policy as a domestic political tool to weaken the country. This is not the first time Congress MP has questioned the centre's strategy in Ladakh. Rahul Gandhi has tweeted more than 10 times over the last 1 year and described the centre's actions as cowardly along the LSE. The BJP hit back at Rahul Gandhi. BJP IT cell head Amit Malviya took to Twitter to say, using fake news which has been rebutted by the Indian Army as a domestic political tool is a new low, even by Rahul Gandhi's low standards.
Media reports of China building infrastructure along LSE is a disturbing and a worrying development, hurting India's national security interest. For the past 1 year, BJP has played a game of hide and seek with the people of India by keeping the entire nation in dark with regards to China's misadventures.
Satta ka sukh bhogne ke liye Gandhi parivar ke Rahul Gandhi kuch bhi kar sakte hain. Aur ye report puri tarah se गलत है. इसके तथ्य ठीक नहीं है और भारत की सेना ने भी इसका खंडन किया हुआ
है. द बीजेपी ऑल्सो एक्यूज राहुल गांधी ऑफ कॉम्प्रोमाइजिंग इंडियाज नेशनल सिक्योरिटी. द इंडियन आर्मी टू रिलीज्ड अ स्टेटमेंट डिनाइंग एनी अटेम्प्ट बाय ईदर साइड टू ऑक्यूपाई द एरियाज वेयर दिस एंगेजमेंट हैज बीन अंडरटेकन. द आर्मी सेड reports of fresh clashes are false and baseless. It also denied any clashes in Galwan or any other area as claimed.
We must believe only when information is put out by the Ministry of Defense or the armed forces. No one else, even an opposition or a ruling party politician statement or any veteran, they do not have or the required inputs.
Still there is a friction, there is a tense. Until and unless the Chinese go back back to what they were in April 2020. India is putting pressure on China that they must also negotiate and disengage from Gogra Hot Spring and Debsang.
As soldiers face off in Ladakh, battle lines are clearly drawn ahead of the parliament session too.
The issue of eastern Ladakh and the Chinese PLA is back in focus after Rahul Gandhi has tweeted about the issue. Though Indian Army and the government have denied any incident of clash, this is a mark of escalation between the government and the opposition just ahead of the upcoming monsoon session. Whether this will take much of the center stage is something to be watched out for. With camera person Ashok Bhanot, this is Kamaljeet Sandhu in Delhi for India Today.
Worrying situation in Kerala. A number of COVID cases going up, and along with that, there are cases of Zika virus that are being reported in Kerala. The health minister of the state has now confirmed to India Today that there is a Zika cluster in Thiruvananthapuram. The cluster is formed within a 3-kilometer radius of the Anayaya region in the capital city. A 24-hour control room has been opened and set up in the state capital. The health department has stepped up surveillance and vigilance. The Kerala government has said that it's also decided to intensify vector control activities and also ensuring that all fogging activities is done. The virus is spread by Aedes species mosquito, and most of those affected do not have any symptoms. There's no treatment for Zika virus yet. Vaccine trials are still underway.
The only that pregnant lady that was first reported turned positive, but quite a few had similar problems where the chikungunya and other tests turned negative. So I feel that this syndrome is going on. This problem is going on for a couple of months, and post-monsoon probably it peaked.
We have to know what is the extent of the spread of the disease in the community and how far it has spread. So any person who is presenting with the typical symptoms, we are sending their samples to the laboratory for confirmation of Zika viral infection.
Monsoons have wreaked havoc in parts of Himachal Pradesh, leading to flash floods in many areas. Tourists have left, but their vehicles are still stuck and left behind in the debris.
Damaged cars, buildings that are now a concrete rubble, roads blocked by debris. Dharamshala is picking up pieces after the destruction wrecked by flash floods and landslides earlier this week. The hill station received 395 mm rainfall over Sunday and Monday, its heaviest downpour in the last 23 years. For residents and tourists, it has been a harrowing time. ...35-year-old Vinod is a taxi operator in the region. His car has suffered huge damage.
स्टेयरिंग तक मलबा भर गया था, जो क्रेन भी नहीं उठा पा रही थी गाड़ी को, इसलिए अब वो खाली करने के लिए बोल के गए हैं, इसलिए हम इसको खाली कर रहे हैं मलबा, और इसमें बहुत भारी गाद भरा हुआ था, मिट्टी पत्थर बहुत अंदर से ससासा तोड़कर पार हो गया है, और ये गाड़ी जो थी सबसे ऊपर में लगी थी, इस वजह से बाकी गाड़ियों का नुकसान कम हो गया, पर इसको ये पूरी तरह से क्षतिग्रस्त हो गई है.
Vinod had taken a loan for this taxi, but the COVID lockdown and now the floods have hit him hard.
पिछले दो साल से जब से टैक्सी ली हुई है, तब से लॉकडाउन का प्रोसेस चली हुई है, ना टैक्सी का काम हो रहा है, ना कुछ, और लोन की किस्तें भी अपने से भरनी पड़ रही है.
Vehicles of many tourist operators are buried in the debris yet to be cleared. Many operators have gone back home.
मलबे जो बाइक फंसी हुई है वो ये कस्टमर की, मतलब जो घूमने आए थे जो पर्यटन थे उनकी है बाइक ये। शायद वो जलंधर के थे, जो कल 4-5 बाइकें भी हमारे हमको बोल रहे थे कि जलंधर पहुंचाने हैं वो बाइकें।
These youngsters have been forced to cut their tour short.
मोस्टली यही एरिया में सिर्फ बाढ़ थी और बाकी सब जगह नॉर्मल बारिश था। तो हम हॉस्टल में रुके हुए थे सब, और हॉस्टल वाला हमें मतलब बता रहा था कि मतलब हौसला दे रहा था।
खाना नहीं था तो एवरीवन वाज शेयरिंग फूड, बिजली वगैरह सब का प्रॉब्लम हुआ बट देन एवरीथिंग वाज मैनेज्ड।
पावर एंड वाटर सप्लाई इज स्टिल एरेटिक एंड दे हैव बीन नाउ कंपेल्ड टू मूव। दे वर ट्रैप्ड इनसाइड देयर होटल्स एंड गेस्ट हाउसेस फॉर 2 डेज। देयर वाज नो फूड, हाउएवर दे मैनेज्ड द नेक्स्ट 2 डेज बट the things became normal and now rescue operation is still on. Vehicles which are still under the debris are being removed. The video journalist Dilip Sahu, this is Manjit Sehgal at Bhatsunag, Dharamshala for India Today.
I'm slipping into a short break here on First Up. The news and updates continue right here on India Today. So stay with me. Thank you for watching.